Oh, recording. Hey, folks. This is Addie, Ryan's wife, FixedByDoc's wife, and Olight has sent us another light to review. So this one is the PL2 Valkyrie. It's an LED weapon light, max lumens of 1,200. Total of 71.5 minutes, I think, battery, if you're using it wisely. It's should be able to throw the light up to 235 meters. It is IPX6, which means you can squirt it with powerful, powerful jets of water, like a really, really, really beyond turbocharged super soaker, for like 3 minutes before you actually have problems. It uses an LED that's a CREE XHP35 HI. It's a pretty huge quality light here, and high powerful stuff. 5-year warranty on it, and they say this is one of the most bright, compact weapon lights on the market. It is, let's see as I read through, powered by two high-capacity CR123A batteries, not just regular ones, but high-capacity ones, because this is such a powerful flashlight. It's got a TIR optic lens, or TIR, I'm not sure if it's TIR or TIR. Again, they're mentioning that 235-meter-long focused beam, still wide enough to see all around you, but also focused in long distance. It has a heavy-duty quick attach and release mount system that lets you put it on a firearm that has a rail, and I have one here that I'm going to try to put it on, with an ambidextrous switch that also lets you use it, so if either if you're right-handed or left-handed, use what you are preferring, and you'll still be able to use the switch, even in a high-stress situation. It's a highly powerful self-defense tool, which can blind an aggressor indoors while still offering an extremely long distance for rifle use. Talked about that already. It says it's applicable on a Glock and MIL-STD-1913. I think that's also Picatinny rails. And it comes for adapters for both. It's got a mute ambidextrous on-off switch. And you can push it forwards directly or hit either side. It's, see, dropping rated for 1 meter. And let me show you that. My camera can focus somehow. There we go. Almost. Let's see. I'm going to take it out of the box now. And I haven't already done so, so this may take a second or two, because they do make these boxes so that they don't just, you know, fall apart when you pick them up, which is good, because otherwise you'd be a little embarrassed at the store. Yeah, there we go. Getting it right out. So here it is. It's kind of, it honestly looks kind of like a one of those little hotel bottles of shampoo, or like a little toy dude. So there's, hopefully that you saw me do the do as it was walking. It does say caution hot, so I'm assuming it's going to be one of those that if you do do have it running for a long distance, it's going to get hot. And there's an open side thing here where you pull this and it pops open, and I was looking to get in there and take that out. So it's already got those batteries in there. Do not recharge. So these are going to be ones that you'll have to get new batteries for and dispose of properly, but it is going to be a huge output. Oh, I like it tells you right there that you want the positive end of the battery in that one and the negative end to touch this one. So, and they already came like that. And now that we have the spacer out, whoa, okay, that turned that on. Maybe you have to open it to close it. Maybe you just have to push to close it. Alright, we'll get the instruction manual and stop messing with it, because that would be the smart thing. Alright, the manual inside the box. Oh, hey, there's supposedly a wrench in here. Oh, there it is. There is a wrench in there. And the little adapter thing. User manual. It's an aluminum alloy structure. It's anodized. It's 3.25 inches long. By 1.44 inches by 1.28 inches. Let's see, pistol installation, battery installation, pull that to open it, put them in, hold the tail cap firmly, and then close the spring lock. Okay, so that spring lock needs to be open. There, okay. Open, close, turn it off. It's getting warm already, and then close. Okay. So, that little tab has to stay open before you close it, then you close it after you've got the top down. So it kind of locks it in place. Take off the film. Did that. Pistol light installation. Pull open the swing arm. Close the swing arm. Pull the swing arm as shown in the picture. Nuts align the slot. Put it on the rail. Turn and fix the swing arm. Oh, okay. Swing arm. One of those, kind of like they have for bike seats and stuff, where you can tighten and close it really quickly. So, we're going to try dropping the flashlight, or the camera. If someone who is not quite weapons tech savvy like me can get this onto this rail quickly. And I'm going to put it on backwards just because you'll be able to see what I'm doing. And get it to stay on there. Then I'm pretty sure anybody can. So that was pretty simple. Alright, so in this case we're not going to have to use the adapter. But they do have a little piece of equipment that would go in there as the adapter to make it fit on the other kind of rails. And lucky me, all I have to do to put it on and off of this rifle, flip that thing open that's loosened it up, and then it comes off. So closing that causes it to kind of tighten up there, so it clamps down real fast on and off. I'm going to close it now just so that it's not getting caught on things. I will drop test this, but I'm not going to really, really drop test it too much, because I think Ryan will probably, when he gets home, want to play with it on the rifles, and I don't think... If I aggressively drop test it more than it should be drop tested, I don't want to bust it. What we will do is we'll splash some water on it in a minute, but right now we're going to turn it on and off. And alright, so they said you push it and it can turn on. Let's turn this headlamp down really low. There. So I can see what I'm doing. Alright, we're going to push it. Do-do-do-do. Somewhere in here. There we go. So that turns it on, off, on, off, push and hold, interesting, okay, and let's see if there's any other things in the manual about what kind of light options we have. English, three different operational methods, constant on and off. Single clutch on either switch. When it's on, another clutch will turn it off. The momentary on or off. When it's off, press and hold either side switch. Let it go to turn it off. Press and hold. Oh, that is bright. Okay. And strobe mode on and off. Press and hold the right at the same time and then release for constant on. Click either side to turn it off. Okay, I think we accidentally did that earlier. We'll turn this light off. Okay. A little bit on. So you can see. Either side, on, off. On, off, that was with the left. And together, turns that on, turns that off. And then if you just press and hold, it's on while you're doing that, and then off when you take it off. So that's kind of cool. That way you don't have to turn it on and off. You just are like, I need a quick peek. Next, we're going to see how far we can throw some light with this turkey. Not focusing too well, but we're going up the, there's the wind turbine, and, there, it's finally in focus. It's not raining, so you can't see how high we're going, but we're on the top of the trees at our house here, and I'm gonna quick slish this with some water, and then we'll take it up. Easier to do a drop test or a dunk test than it is a splash test. That and set this here and let's get off of there. You're not supposed to be there. Splash it. Sloosh. Sloosh. Sploosh. Sploosh. Okay, I know those aren't powerful jets and I'm there. Got some on there. But it's not actually rated for full and total submersion for 3 minutes at a meter or anything like that. It's pull it full jet rated, so we're gonna give it a try. Alright, that's off. Now, poke a button, back on, poke a button off, poke a button on, off. Alright, so getting it splooshy wet has not damaged its functionality, which is not surprising. Olights generally are pretty tough cookies. And I'm heading up towards the driveway because I have a sneaky feeling you're going to be able to see a lot farther down the road than you will through the trees. So here we go. Gate's open, gate's closed. Maybe that raccoon will come by and I can really irritate its eyes and maybe it'll never come back again. Having a raccoon war. Alright, just for some travel here, I'm going to turn on my headlamp a little bit so I can see where I'm going and not use up all these batteries before I show you how far it really can go. Not that they'd wear out, but I really want them fresh and juicy to give you the best show I can. Plus, and honestly, I do better with a little less light. Alright, we are at the road. You can see there's the Christmas lights, or the decorative lights on our mailbox. Here we go with the light. It's on. There's my sneakers going down the road. My cat's out, I can hear him. There's those signs over there. Oh, there he is, he's in the woods. He's not happy about being flashed. So this is definitely going to take you some serious distance. I'm not sure if the camera's picking it up, but this is going as far down the road, basically, as I can see before the curve. So, and actually, the reflector down way down there is reflecting back to me. I think you might have just caught a flicker of it. But that's way down there. Yeah, you can kind of see it on the camera. That's a good distance down there. We're definitely picking up power pole number one. Here's the closest one. There's the mailbox. Grass and stuff. Down to that first power pole. Down to the second. I'm being stalked by, I think it's a cat. It is a cat. Oh gosh, good. Glad it wasn't the raccoon. Hi, Gnar. He's down there. Hey, buddy. Yeah, you're definitely lit up with this. Don't look at it. Oh my gosh, and it is getting warm. So this is not something you'd really want to be carrying around in your hand long term, because it's getting very, very warm. As it says, caution hot. But you can see there's that power pole. I think that's the second one. First one. Second one. And remember, this isn't like a camera with great night vision or anything. So, and then beyond it, even there's the reflector. And so, we'll drop it. I don't want to do it. Okay, I'm 5 feet something, and a meter is about, let's say, sternum high on me. Here we go. Let me zoom out. Zoom back away from zoomed in. Sorry, I managed to hit the power button instead of the, turn the zoom back off button. Oh, hey, there's those pretty flowers. But here we go. Don't drop it on the cat. It is dropped. Cat was like, what was that? Still working. It's still functioning. Boom, there it goes again. Ah! Ooh, something just turboed over me and I heard the wing flash. Creepy. On and off still works. Both sides. Strobe still works. Off still works. Press and hold still works. And it's definitely still warm. Alright. Thanks for watching. I think that's all I'm going to do with this for now.